as I been through this journey, I always feel that one should always be, you know, because this exam doesn't give instant success. Sometimes it gives success in 1 second, and sometimes for some people it gives success in 6 seconds. So it doesn't depend upon the amount of work you do, or there are a lot of factors surrounding this examination, keeping the success ratio, which is to be very low. So I feel one should always be motivated when one is coming in this exam. So there is nothing wrong in, you know, clearing it in first attempt. That is the best thing to do. But you should be in a, you should have a mindset such that if I don't clear it up, I'm not leaving the preparation altogether. I'm ready to slog it for how much ever I want, based on their own.
So thank you, and I welcome Rishikesh Reddy, who has got ranked 95 in the Civil Services Examination 2019. And it's my privilege to host you in this session. So first of all, congratulations. And I would like to ask you to share your journey in a very short about your UPSC journey.
Hello everyone, I'm Rishikesh. I secured All India Rank 95 in Civil Service Examination 2019. This was my fifth attempt. I already secured a rank of 374 in Civil Service Examination 2017, and for which I got allotted to Indian Railway Traffic Service, and I'm undergoing training in that service currently. So I'd be joining Indian Police Service based on 2019 exam.
Okay, thank you. So as you said, like, you have appeared in the five attempts. So what kept you going, and how to be motivated for such a long time? Although you cleared in the third attempt also, but even after that, you continued.
So it's basically, for me, it was personally from childhood, there were factors motivating me to go for IAS or IPS, because my father, as I said long back in many of the interactions too, that my father planted that seed, like from very early ages. So I think so that was, that motivation was always there. I am someone who always likes to have targets and then achieving them. So always was not satisfied with my rank in the third attempt. So I wanted to give one more attempt and then see if I can improve my rank. So okay. Here I am today.
Okay, great. So a journey for the excellence. Great.
Yeah.
So now it's the time for the mains examination preparation. And prelims is difficult, but I think mains is more difficult, because it's really difficult to judge how is the level of preparation and how much to cover and so on. So what are your views on how to go for the GS mains preparation?
One of the fundamental thing I think in GS and for the optional, I feel the first basic thing is you have to complete the syllabus. There is no substitute to it. You have to cover each and every thing which UPSC has given in the syllabus sheet. You do it from anywhere, have a basic knowledge about everything which is given in the syllabus. There can't be no ifs and buts about that. After doing that, I feel the way the mains examination is going towards it, I don't think UPSC is asking for any typical questions which used to come 3-4 years back. I think it's more of UPSC is throwing surprises at people, and I think for that, in order to be ready for that questions, so I think you need a lot of writing practice. I personally feel that. So once you have a good writing practice, so you can answer any kind of question which you can. Why I say writing practice is more important is because you won't be reading anything differently for the kind of questions which are coming. The reading part will be similar. It's just that the application part, it will depend upon how much you have attempted earlier, how many tests have you given earlier. So that once any kind of new question comes, so you can easily put the knowledge you have for the question. So I think that is important to write as many number of tests as you can.
Yeah, that's a very important point you have touched. So Rishikesh, what do you think about daily answer writing? What is the importance of daily answer writing? And what is the role of full length test?
See, as I said, I personally believe in answer writing because I think it not only shows, it not only practice, it also not only makes you prepared for the final exam, but it also gives you a structure of preparation. Like if you're writing answers, you will know where you are deficient. You will know where you want to improve upon. You will know what you want to do next. So it gives a targeted, you know, approach to this. So for this, you can approach this answer writing in two ways. I did it in two ways. I used to write answers daily. It may be two questions or three questions, and I used to use different forum for it. Apart from that, I also used to depend on full length tests. So full length tests, I gave around 7 to 8 full length tests. So it depends upon each individual to give how many full length tests they want till their comfort zone. But I think it is very important to give full length tests after also practicing daily answers, because full length tests gives you an idea on how to approach the paper in the final exam. So, and also you can do actually devise your own strategies to attempt. How do you attempt? Do you go from first question to 20th question without leaving anything, or you attempt 15 markers first or 10 markers first, or if you want to attempt the questions, you know, first. So you make your own strategy based on your mock test. So mock test prepare you for the final test, like how you want to approach that paper. So that is why it is important, and it also enables you to stick to that time limit very well. So I think that for that sake, it's very important.
So both daily answer writing and the full length test, we should have a mix of both.
I personally feel that you don't spend much time on daily answer writing, maybe two to three questions every day, but writing every day is very important because it keeps you in touch. That some people have very good knowledge, but they can't express it properly. So by writing answers, I feel you can express things properly. You can get things in a flow. So your mind becomes less cluttered.
Yeah. I mean, the things become systematized, and on a daily basis, we improve actually.
Yes.
Absolutely. True. And how does our program of daily answer writing help you? Did you get benefit from that? And what is your opinion about that?
So basically last year I wanted, rather than writing, I used to write answers on my own, but last year what I wanted is I wanted something different. I wanted something to push me, give me some daily questions and evaluate it on the daily basis. Because what happens is at one point of time, if you want to write questions, you either attempt previous year's test series question, which you have already done, or you have to attempt the previous year's mains test series, UPSC test. But after one point of time, once you have done those, so you want questions to update itself. So I think daily answer writing from your website, it helped me to get newer questions. It helped me to religiously write those answers every day and also get them evaluated. So this was good idea. Like even some days, even when I missed it, so I used to take your answers and then I used to compare, then I used to read at least those things. So it used to cover my current affairs and also help me, push me to write the answers regularly. So people who do not have a peer group, I think this is a very good option to write.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you for giving your opinion on that. So after mains is the interview. What is your take on that? I think you must have gone through multiple interviews, at least two to hai aapke journey mein.
Three interviews.
Okay.
I have given three interviews. I feel in interview, the most important thing is your DAF. So you have your DAF in front of you. You have to be very, very thorough with it. And I feel the thing which determines your interview score is your confidence. I mean, I have seen it's very easy to say to be confident, but at the same time, being confident, after going to UPSC Bhavan, it's very difficult. But you have to be confident because you have to think that you have come to till this stage. I mean, you are one among just the 2,500 odd people who will be appearing for interview. So I think you should take a lot of confidence from that fact. And with that confidence, I think your answer, the way you answer dramatically improves. I think that is a good way forward.
Absolutely.
So be confident, do your DAF well, and also hone your personality. Like as my answer writing is very important for mains, I think public speaking and any form of speaking is very important for interview, because you'll be able to express very well. So what I used to do was I used to stand in front of mirror and I used to talk so that I can observe how I've been talking, how I can respond, how I'm appearing when I'm answering. So I think you have to practice, because as they say, practice makes man perfect. So it's either for mains or for pre or for interview, there requires a lot of practice. Reading doesn't suffice for this examination is what I strongly believe.
I also came across a lot of notes circulating in the social media from your side. I mean, and that shows the kind of effort that you must have put in. So what is your opinion? Should every aspirant prepare that kind of note, or how did you go about that? I mean, that is something unique I have seen. A very few people
I feel it's up to an individual to make his own notes or to read from some other's notes. I think it's up to an individual. But for me, I always used to revise things. And what used to happen is like because in civil services, we read from too many sources. We have so many number of sources, and to cover such a vast syllabus, you require so many sources. But for me, what used to happen is when there are so many sources, in order to revise them, I used to get all tensed up in the end. So I couldn't revise from them. So I wanted a concise notes, which I can revise in the last month before pre or before mains. So that is I decided in my first attempt only, I'll do notes. I will make a very simplified and concise notes for every topic, so that even in the last 1 month, I should not be reading anything else. I would be just depending on my notes to finish the syllabus. So that is when I started doing notes from my very first attempt. And I used to do it in the manner I like, wherever sometimes I used to write and then I used to put that photo of that in my notes. So it depends upon each individual. Some people doesn't require the amount of revision which I require. I tend to forget things very easily, so I need to revise things very well. So I used to make a concise notes in my own language. I think that is very helpful if people do it. I really, I'm a big supporter of this notes, people making their own notes, because it will be written in your own language. So when you read it, you will easily understand it. You'll get the crux of it. So you won't have to waste so much time in revising things which you have read earlier. You can get the facts very easily.
Absolutely.
You can revise fast.
Absolutely. Our mind is designed in a way that it absorbs our handwriting in much easier way. It's just like eating our own cooked food. That's very easy.
Either handwriting or your own typed notes. I used to never write it in the paper, because the digital notes are much easier. You can always... So I used to always make a digital note for myself.
Yeah, sure. So any last 2 points you want to share with the aspirants, which you really learned from your own journey, and if students get that, it can really benefit them? Any 2 points?
I always feel that there must always be, there can't be 2 points or 3 points, but as I been through this journey, I always feel that one should always be, because this exam doesn't give instant success. Sometimes it gives success in first second, and sometimes for some people it gives success in sixth attempt. So it doesn't depend upon the amount of work you do, or there are a lot of factors surrounding this examination and keeping the success ratio, which is to be very low. So I feel one should always be motivated when one is coming in this exam. So there is nothing wrong in clearing it in first attempt. That is the best thing to do. But you should be you should have a mindset such that if I don't clear it up, I'm not leaving it. I'm not leaving the preparation altogether. I'm ready to slog it for how much ever I want, based on their own individual preferences. So I feel that having that mindset really helps, because sometimes you don't get success very fast. So I think this is one very important thing which I wanted to tell everyone. And second thing I wanted to tell is do not take this any process of this examination very lightly. Either prelims, in my first attempt, I've cleared interview. I went till interview, and second attempt, I couldn't clear mains itself. And third attempt, I got the final result, and in the fourth attempt, I couldn't clear pre itself. So there are like lots of ups and downs in the examination. It's very competitive. You never take anything lightly. I don't think people take it lightly, but just for for some people who may think, do not take things like, and always, one more thing I wanted to say is about the amount of notes which are coming in. I see there's tremendous proliferation in the amount of material which one has access to. I think that is a boon and a bane at the same time. So just stick to one resource which you want, and always try to revise them and then use them rather than, diversifying your sources. One source always helps. It's good.
Yeah. Thank you for sharing your journey and your insight from your own experience. And you have touched those areas which really require a lot of attention. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All the best for your future.
Thank you. Thank you so much.